Let's look at integration by parts. Given a function of product of two functions to integrate, you can use the method which we have discussed previously, that is by algebraic substitution. Another method that you can use to solve it is integration by parts. So I will not go through the theoretical parts, but I'll just solve this example direct for us to see. In this method, what you do, you use derivatives and antiderivatives of the partial products of functions to get its integral. For example, we know that from product rule of differentiation that if you differentiate a product of two functions, that is f prime of x, when f of x is a product of two functions, that may be u and v, to get its derivative, that is the duv over dx with respect to x, if u and v are functions of x, the derivative becomes, given that you hold one part, you hold the u, you get dv over dx, then you add by holding v, you get du over dx, then you sum them. So if you multiply both sides by dx, you'll get that duv is equal to udv plus vdu. So we can make udv the subject and get that udv is equal to duv minus vdu. So you can integrate both sides and get the integral of udv to be equal to uv, if you integrate this side, if you integrate both sides, minus integral of v du. So this is the method that we use to solve the integrals of such function by partial, by in parts. So let's solve this first example and see how we get it. So we shall use that one as our reference formula in this format, that integral is given as u dv is given as uv minus integral of v du. So if this is our formula, we let, and you are now told to integrate cosine of 2x exponential of 3x dx, we are told to integrate with respect to x, and this one is indefinite integral because we have not been given the boundaries, so we just solve it direct in this format. You let, so let's have the sinusoidal part to be u, let u to be equal to cosine of 2x. If u is cosine of 2x, what shall be du? Du dx with respect to x shall be, if you differentiate this function with respect to x, you'll get, if you differentiate a cosine, you get the negative sign, but the coefficient precedes, so it comes negative 2 sine of 2x. And we also let also dv to be equal to exponential of negative 3x. That is our dv. So how do we get v? We get v by integrating. So if we integrate exponential function, the coefficients remain the same as that one, but the power comes down. Negative 3 goes there. So we have got u du, we have got v and dv. So we can substitute in this formula for us to get the actual integral. So the integral of u dv shall be equal to uv. So uv multiplied in that format, that is cosine of 2x multiplied by exponential of negative 3x over negative 3, you multiply in that format, minus the integral of v du, that is negative exponential of 3x over 3 in that format, multiplied by u, multiplied by du, sorry, that is negative 2 sine of 2x in that format, you integrate with respect to x. If you do that, you'll get that this one is equal to, you can start with the coefficient first, that would be negative 1 over 3 cosine of 2x exponential of negative 3x. So that one is this part solved. So this and this, this negative sign and this one cancels out, you end up with minus integral of 2 over 3 sine of 2x exponential of negative 3x as it was before, and you integrate with respect to x. After getting that, you now proceed and say, how do you solve for the next part? The next part now becomes in this format again. we can now integrate this one further again, and what we are solving, we found that integral of cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x, is equal to uv, which we found here to be a third cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x, minus the integral of 2 over 3 sine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x dx. So we can solve this part again. But before we proceed, to bring some mathematical smartness, you let integral of cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x, to be with respect to x, as we are integrating dx, to be equal to a letter I, so that we can bring some mathematical smartness. So we let this side to be equal to I. So we say that I is equal to negative a third cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x, minus integral of 2 over 3 sine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x dx. So we can solve this part again by parts, by letting, we have let the sinusoidal part to be u. So again, we let the sinusoidal part to be u. So let again u to be equal to sine of 2x. U is sine of 2x. Very interesting. What shall be du? Du shall be equal to the differential of a cos, a sine gives you a positive sign and the coefficient places. So that one will be 2 cosine of 2x as our du. Then dv to be equal to exponential of negative 3x. So what shall be v? You integrate again. If you integrate an exponential, you'll get the same coefficients of power, but you divide it by the coefficient there in that format. So we have got everything. We can replace again in our formula and find that I is equal to negative 1 over 3 cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x, minus, so is less everything, 2 over 3 is a coefficient, you can put it outside there. The integral of this by parts, you take this formula, that is uv. So what's our uv? U is sine and this is v. That shall be sine of exponent, sine, negative sine 2x, exponential of negative 3x, everything divided by 3 in that format. That is our uv. Then minus again the integral of v du. So this is our v and this is our du. So you add them together. That one becomes exponential, this one times this one. That is exponential of, let's start with the coefficient part. That's cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x over negative 3 in that format. So if you add it in that format, everything can be solved in this format. That is I to be equal to negative a third cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x. Then we multiply, we open that bracket using the coefficient outside here, that is negative 2 over 3. So this is negative 2 over 3 multiplied here, it becomes positive 2 over 9, because this one multiplies by this in that format, sine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x. So this negative sign and this one cancels out. So this negative proceeds in that order. So if you multiply everything, this negative 2 and this negative 2 sums up in that format and you get negative 4. 3 and 3 gives you over 9. The integral of this one is cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x, dx. But if you confirm this part and what we are left to be equal to I are the same. So we can say I to be equal to negative a third cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x in that format, plus 2 over 9 sine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x, minus 4 over 9 I. minus 4/9i, because this one is what we are left to be equal to I, and it is actually what we are solving. So we can collect the like terms in that parameter for us to solve. We can collect the like terms in this format. We can now bring the 4/9i to this side to get that I plus 4/9i to be equal to the other side now. That is negative 1/3 cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x in that format, plus 2/9 sine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x in that format. So we can add these two together. That is, that format will get I plus I, this one, I plus 4/9i, that one you add, you'll get 13/9i to be equal to negative 1/3 cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x, then plus 2/9 sine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x in that format. But our interest was to get I, so you multiply both sides by 9/13. If you do multiply both sides by 9/13, these sides are cancelled, you end up with I to be equal to 9/13. If you multiply in that format, you'll get negative 1/39, because this 9 will cancel with this 3 in that format. No, it will, sorry, this one cancel here, remain with 3, so it becomes 3/13. Sorry, cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x. Then this sign and that one cancels out, you end up with 2/13 sine of 2x, exponential of negative 13x. So you can factor out everything and get here 1/13 is common, 1/13 into, you start with this one because this side is negative, into 2, 9/13 is common and the exponential of negative 3x is also common, so we can factor out everything. So it is 1/13 exponential of negative 3x into, here it goes 2, so that is 2 sine 2x, then the negative is minus 3 cosine of 2x. So that one is our integral, but we add another constant, c, to be the integral of what we were solving as cosine of 2x, exponential of negative 3x, dx. So that's how you solve that integral by parts. Very interesting, very interesting. So to solve by parts, you just get the derivatives and antiderivatives of the partial parts. That's why we call it integration by parts. You take one part, you get the derivative, and the other part, you get the antiderivative, then you solve it. So we can do another example. We can do another example in this format for us to confirm. In that one, we solve an exponential function multiplied by a sinusoidal function. So we can do another one involving a polynomial multiplied by an exponential. For example, you are told to integrate exponential x cubed multiplied by exponential of negative 2 with respect to x. This is a product of two functions. So let this one be our second example in that format. You are told to integrate. The first point, we know that the integral of such function is given that integral of u dv is equal to uv minus v du in that format. So this basically, this is the formula that we are relying on. But you do it twice, the second integral will be equal to the what we are integrating first. You collect the like terms, then you get the integral that we are looking for. So in this case, we let the polynomial to be u. So let u to be equal to x cubed. U to be equal to x cubed. So what shall be du? If you differentiate x cubed with respect to x, it shall be 3x squared. Then again, dv should be equal to exponential of negative 2x in that format. Exponential of negative 2x. So, what shall be our v? You integrate this one. If you integrate an exponential, the coefficient remain the same. but you divide it by the coefficient in that format. So that one is v. So our integral shall be the integral of v du, u dv is given by that formula. So we replace. So integral, we let this one, again also let integral of x cubed exponential of negative 2x dx to be equal to I at that first instance. So I shall be equal to what we've got here. So that one shall be uv, that is x cubed multiplied by exponential of negative 2x over negative 2 minus the integral of v du, that one. So that one shall be negative 3 over 2 x squared exponential of negative 2x in that format. So we can synthesize it, we can cancel this negative sign and this one and get that I to be equal to x cubed exponential of negative 2x over 2 negative 2 in that format. This negative and this negative becomes a positive plus, then 2 over 3 over 2 can comes outside for it's a constant. Then you integrate x squared exponential of negative 2x. With respect to x, in both cases we are integrating with respect to x. So after doing that, this one is another product of two functions that can be integrated. So we do it again. We now let u to be equal to exponential of negative 2x. What shall be du? Du, if we differentiate an exponential, it becomes the same but the coefficient received. That one shall be negative 2, exponential of negative 2x. Then dv now to be equal to x squared. So what shall be v? If you integrate that one, you'll get x cubed over 3. So that is your v. So you can replace it again in that formula, get that I to be equal to negative 1 over 2 x cubed exponential of negative 2x, so that is this part, plus 3 over 2 into, if you integrate this one, it is uv, and you have got u here and v here, u here and v here, that one gives us exponential of negative 2x multiplied by x cubed over three, then minus the integral of v du. Since we have reversed the what we were integrating, so now we reverse the sign. So this one v du, you multiply that, that one shall be the integral. You reverse the sign because you have reversed what you are doing. So this one times this one gives you 2 negative 2 exponential of negative 2x, then multiplied by exponential x cubed over 3 dx. So if you expand the bracket, it becomes in this format I is equal to negative 1/2 x cubed exponential of negative 2x plus, let's open the bracket, this and this becomes 1/2 x cubed exponential of negative 2x. Then that one becomes minus this one, and that one cancels out, this and that one cancels out. So you end up with minus the integral of x cubed exponential of negative 2x dx. And if you compare this one with I, it's actually I. That one is actually I, what we had declared here. So you can say I to be equal to 1/2 x cubed exponential of negative 2x plus 1/2 x, here we had x cubed again, exponential of negative 2x. They are summing in that format minus I. So if you bring it this side, it will be added on. So it will be 2i to be equal to this and this. If you sum them, 1/2 x power 3 exponential of negative 2x, then plus 1/2 x squared exponential of negative 2x. So you divide both sides by 2, this side by 2. Then you get, by 2. If you divide by 2, you end up with the same answer as the integral. You'll end up with the integral of that function as, end up with integral of x cubed exponential negative 2x to be equal to, with respect to x, to be equal to, everything divided by 2 will give you 1 over 4 into bracket x cubed exponential of negative 2x, then plus x squared exponential of negative 2x, then you add another constant c in that format. So we can use this process of integration by the parts to solve different integrals. So we shall proceed next time. After that point, thank you.